Thanks for joining us for a special edition of Fox 40 News. I'm Joe Khalil. That new footage shows officers being put into an almost impossible situation, running for cover with no idea where the suspect, who, by the way, has an AR-15 style rifle, is shooting from.
We're going to tackle a lot tonight, diving deeper into issues of immigration, how past administrations have handled immigration families at the border, and we're going to hear from experts on where the divisive issue goes from here.
Well, the debate on exactly how that money is being spent went on for 4 hours tonight. People in some city districts feel like they've been left out of the spending plan. Fox 40's Sinceri Tonsil was there for that tense debate. You're just now live in Sacramento with more. Sinceri, a lot of passion here on really all sides of this. Okay, so you have just heard from the chief of police in Gilroy answering questions that too many police chiefs across this country have had to answer after now having a mass shooting in his community. So here's what we know now after hearing the chief. 15 people hurt, 4 dead, including the shooter.
And I want to pose this to you, Karen, because that was the concern, right? That there were just simply too many Democrats in these races and that they were taking votes away from each other.
Continuing to follow our breaking news right now, a female Sacramento police officer has been shot in North Sacramento, and we want to stress that she was shot with a rifle. This was an active shooter situation. She was shot around 6:10, and it wasn't until about 45 minutes later or so that her fellow officers were finally able to go and get her. So her injuries right now are serious, but as you can imagine, because of that rifle shot, certainly a dire situation. What questions do you still want answered that maybe were not answered in the report that you think you might be able to get through the congressional oversight process?
And I'm Joe Khalil. Now, the Clark family just wrapped up their press conference a short time ago, and as you heard, they're calling for District Attorney Anne Marie Schubert to be fired, and they're calling Clark's death murder.
Let's hypothetically say this week we see another aggressive step from Iran. What does a proportional response from the United States look like at that point?
We've been following this story since then, but tonight we're hearing from family members of those victims for the first time. So let's bring in Fox 40's Christy Gross from Stockton. Christy, you were there today. Definitely an emotional one for family members and for loved ones who are now having to deal with this loss.
We're going to get to that in a minute. I do want to start with just a couple of new details that we did get coming out of this press conference, and that is about two warrants primarily. One search warrant that was issued for a car that they police believe belonged to the suspect, Santino Lagan.
Fox 40's Kay Reseed spoke with that little boy's mother today. So, Kay, you know his mom's been at every single one of these court hearings. She's been waiting for this autopsy report to come out, right?
Really, the eyes of the world on this story. Now, rescuers are racing against the clock to save the other 8 boys and their coach, who are still inside.
Governor, you've run for president 3 times. Yeah. What does the Democratic Party need right now in terms of a leader that might combat Trump? And how would you define who the Democratic Party is?
This vigil to pray for the 3 people who were killed and the dozen people who are still recovering now, set to begin in about a half hour, but we got here a half hour ago, and since then it has really just ballooned. I mean, you can see just by the sheer amount of people that have come and that have shown up, what kind of support they have for this entire community.
CAL FIRE says those buildings that have been destroyed are not homes, but a lot of people who've been evacuated tonight say they are worried about their properties. Fox 40's Bridget Burlow joins us now live in Yolo County from the front lines of this fire. Bridget, what's the latest?
All eyes are on Singapore heading into this week as President Trump and North Korean leader Kim Jong-un prepare to make history.
Anytime we have tragedies like this, we often hear stories about unsung heroes that do heroic things in the face of death and danger. And we're going to send it over to Eric Rucker now in Chico with one of those stories. Eric.
Now, the global super tanker, it's impressive to see. It's stationed at McClellan Air Force Base now. And CAL FIRE crews have already gotten approval to begin drops. Fox 40's Ben Deasy spoke with some officials joining us now live from the base. Ben, I imagine they're hoping this is going to make a big difference for them.
LeBron James?
Maybe.
We'll have to wait and see.
Yeah. You know, he may have gotten those acting skills for those flops in the playoffs sometimes.
Now you're going in another direction.
Cheap shot? I'm sorry. I like LeBron. That was uncalled for.